Hundreds of people were killed at a Gaza City hospital. Hamas blames Israel for the blast, but Israel says the hospital was hit by a rocket misfired by Palestinian militants in the Gaza Strip. The attack comes just one day before President Biden is supposed to go to the region to show support for Israel. Fox's Madeline Rivera has more.
I'm thinking about it.
Secretary of State Antony Blinken still making the rounds in the Middle East, pushing for a diplomatic solution as the fighting between Israel and Hamas intensifies. And on Wednesday, his boss, President Biden, is expected to visit the region, meeting with his counterparts in Israel and Jordan to offer his support ahead of a likely ground assault inside Gaza.
There will be U.S. involvement. Israel will not be alone. From our perspective, it's something that we really feel. It gives us strength.
And American involvement in this war is deepening. The Pentagon issuing ready-to-deploy orders to some 2,000 troops in the region, but say they'll be used for military advising and medical support, not for combat. And none are expected to be deployed inside the Gaza Strip.
We know we have special operators on the ground right now assisting, advising. I think they would be there also if we were able to locate Americans.
Meanwhile, Israeli airstrikes are continuing to target Hamas, but Palestinian officials say they're increasingly hitting civilians as well. Israel insists every airstrike is against a legitimate military target, claiming a, quote, large number had been called off to avoid civilian casualties. But in the Strip itself, a major humanitarian crisis is now unfolding.
Scant shelter, fast depleting food supplies, little or no access to clean water, sanitation, medicine, and other basic needs.
And officials here in Israel are gearing up for a long fight, saying it could take months or years to fully defeat Hamas. In Jerusalem, Mather Avera, Fox News.